Warning: the hidden links between pancreatitis and diabetes revealed. Have you heard about diabetes? Probably. What about pancreatitis? Maybe you felt its effects with severe and debilitating upper abdomen pain. But what if I told you that these two conditions are far more connected than you realize? Can erratic glucose levels trigger a full-blown pancreatic crisis? And can having pancreatitis actually cause you to develop type 2 diabetes? In this video, I'll expose the hidden continuum between your blood sugar and pancreatitis, and I'll show you 4 specific types of food that can do serious harm to your diabetes management and your pancreatic health. I'm also revealing a few key diabetes-fighting, pancreas-helping foods you won't want to miss. So let's dive into the hidden links between pancreatitis and diabetes, and the 4 worst foods for your pancreas. Of course, your pancreas is a key organ for your blood sugar management, as this is the place where your insulin gets made. Within your pancreas are specialized clusters of cells called islets of Langerhans. That sounds quite magical, and in fact, these cells are quite wondrous, as they produce the insulin your body requires for utilizing your glucose for energy. Your pancreas is also responsible for producing hormones that signal your liver to release stored glucose, along with hormones that help to regulate your appetite. So all in all, this organ is of vital importance to your weight management, cholesterol levels, and insulin sensitivity. Now, coming up, I'll show you 4 main types of food to avoid. These ingredients may heighten your blood sugar and your risk of pancreatic damage. And be sure to stick around to the end of this video to learn about some of the best foods for your pancreas. First, I bet you're wondering, what is pancreatitis? Well, it's basically inflammation of the pancreas. You can have acute pancreatitis with severe pain brought about by sudden and serious factors, like having a gallstone. Chronic pancreatitis may be less painful, but this inflammation can be long-lasting and may never fully heal. Chronic pancreatitis can also affect your digestive system and its ability to absorb nutrients. But can having high blood sugar lead to inflammation of the pancreas? And on the flip side, can having pancreatitis lead to worsened blood sugar management? And why? I'll answer these questions in just a sec. But real quick, the team and I here at Diabetes Smarts want to say thanks so much for watching. And we want to hear what you think about diabetes management. Have you experienced pancreatic pain? And if so, what did you do about it? Comment below to let us know. Don't forget to like and subscribe, and stay tuned to the end of this video to learn which foods actually help your pancreas. But right now, it's time for me to break down the links between pancreatitis and diabetes. First, let's get a few decidedly non-diabetes-related causes of pancreatitis out of the way. As I already mentioned, gallstones, which can block the pancreatic duct, prevents normal release of pancreatic enzymes. In turn, this can create inflammation in the pancreas. Another major reason for your pancreatitis? Well, it could be due to excessive alcohol consumption. Alcoholic beverages can damage pancreatic cells and potentially cause the premature activation of pancreatic enzymes, which will inflame the pancreas. Are you a smoker? Well, regular tobacco use can raise your risk of developing chronic pancreatitis and pancreatic cancer. Certain infections and genetic mutations can also lead to pancreatic inflammation. Sometimes a tumor or cyst can block your pancreatic ducts and lead to enzyme buildup and inflammation. Even surgery complications can trigger trouble in your pancreas. So clearly, there are a variety of reasons why your pancreas may be inflamed, some of which are just not in your control. But when it comes to diabetes and pancreatitis, what are the links, and what treatments, if any, are actually in your control? Well, let's break it all down. In general, thanks to a complex interplay of metabolic, inflammatory, and hormonal factors, having pancreatitis, whether acute or chronic, can damage your insulin-producing beta cells within your pancreas. Naturally, this can lead to impaired glucose regulation. On the other hand, having poorly controlled blood sugar especially when accompanied by high cholesterol levels, can lead to blood fat toxicity and oxidative stress in pancreatic tissue. Research has found that hyperglycemia, or chronic high blood sugar levels, promotes pancreatic fibrosis and pancreatic inflammation, and it worsens the damage over time. Plus, studies show a main common denominator between diabetes and pancreatitis is hypertriglyceridemia, or chronic high levels of triglycerides. Data shows that about one-third of all adults suffer from this condition, and as much as 60% of type 2 diabetics also have hypertriglyceridemia. Much like high cholesterol, high triglycerides can damage your cardiovascular system, and it can lead to inflammation, especially in your pancreas. Also, certain diabetes medications have been found to increase the risk of pancreatic strain, and persistent insulin resistance may further damage your pancreatic function. So, there is a clear, bidirectional relationship between diabetes and pancreatitis. In fact, U.S. studies have concluded that people with chronic elevated blood sugar levels are 2 to 3 times more likely to develop acute pancreatitis than those with better controlled glucose levels. And this highlights the importance of finding effective strategies for managing both conditions if you wish to prevent a cycle of worsening inflammation, metabolic dysfunction, and damage to your very important pancreas. That leads us to the big question: which foods damage your blood sugar and your pancreas? Let's start with the most obvious answer: refined sugar foods and drinks. Of course, foods that supply this highly refined, simple sugar will not give you much or any dietary fiber to help your body manage that blood sugar spiking glucose load. And this is the main reason why regular consumption of sugary treats, like candies, cookies, and soft drinks, will undoubtedly raise your risk of insulin resistance, type 2 diabetes, and heart disease. But this can set off a cascade of damage to other areas of your body, including your pancreas. In fact, research shows that having chronic hyperglycemia from excessive sugar intake promotes oxidative stress and inflammation in your pancreatic tissue, which can damage your insulin-producing beta cells. Obviously, eating too many refined sugar foods will also increase your body's insulin demand, and high output of insulin from your pancreas can further contribute to pancreatic inflammation. Meanwhile, did you know high sugar intake promotes lipogenesis, or fat production in your body? And this can lead to fat accumulation in your pancreatic tissue, which will weaken your insulin secretion, thereby worsening your glucose regulation and your pancreatic health. Next, do your best to cut back on red meat and processed meats. Red meat and processed meats, like sausage, bacon, and deli meats, start off as a red alert food for your blood sugar and your weight, as they are loaded with artery-clogging saturated fats. This type of fat can increase your LDL cholesterol, the type associated with arterial blockages and cardiovascular damage. Overconsuming saturated fats instead of more heart-healthy unsaturated fats has also been shown to heighten your risk of obesity, diabetes, and some forms of cancer. But red and processed meats can really harm your diabetes control and your pancreatic health due to certain carcinogenic substances like heterocyclic amines and polycyclic aromatic hydrocarbons, which can form within red and processed meats when they are cooked at high temperatures. These damaging compounds have been found to increase the risk of pancreatic issues, especially pancreatic cancer. Deep-fried red meat can also form harmful advanced glycation end products, which are linked to chronic inflammation and oxidative stress, further increasing your pancreatic cancer risk. Red meat also contains heme iron, which can create free radical damage, oxidative stress, and even DNA damage. This too can contribute to your pancreatic cancer risk. But which foods help your pancreas and your blood sugar? Stick around, because a little later in this video, I'll show you some specific types of foods you should absolutely eat on a regular basis. Now, it also makes sense to watch your intake of salty snacks. High sodium intake is associated with several diabetes-related issues, including weight gain, chronic inflammation, oxidative stress, and obviously hypertension, or chronic high blood pressure. Sodium-induced hypertension can reduce your blood flow, and that can very much impair nutrient and oxygen delivery to your pancreas. In turn, that harms your pancreatic cell survival, as well as your insulin secretion. So overdoing your salt consumption can therefore lead to worsened glucose management, heightened insulin resistance, and chronic elevated blood sugar levels. These diabetes symptoms can further stress your pancreatic beta cells and increase your risk of impaired diabetes control and serious pancreatic damage. Plus, many salty foods, including highly processed deli meats that utilize sodium for preservation purposes, may contain toxic compounds, including nitrosamines, which can further contribute to your pancreatic cancer risk. Now, when it comes to cooking, beware of using too much margarine and butter. Both butter and margarine will give you a huge helping of saturated fat. This not only heightens your risk of obesity and diabetes, it contributes to systemic inflammation and oxidative stress, which can impair your pancreatic beta cell function. Plus, eating too much saturated fat can lead to increased storage of visceral fat, the type of fat that can accumulate in between your organs. This will also worsen your insulin resistance and your insulin secretion from your pancreas, while also increasing the buildup of fat in and around your pancreas. Now, while margarine does contain a bit less saturated fat than real butter, this fake butter can take it to the next level of unhealthiness with its inclusion of toxic trans fats. Trans fatty acids have been shown to worsen insulin resistance, increase pancreatic stress, and impair pancreatic beta cell function. Trans fats can also increase your risk for a slew of unwanted conditions, including some forms of cancer. Okay, so now you know why these four main types of food can be extremely problematic for your blood sugar control and your risk of developing pancreatitis and other pancreatic issues. But it's not all bad news. I'd like to leave you with a few food options that can actually help your pancreas and your diabetes management. So, try anthocyanin-rich, fiber-packed fruits, especially berries, red grapes, and apples. Antioxidant-rich, fiber-loaded vegetables, especially broccoli, and cauliflower. Lean protein meats, especially fatty fish, like salmon and tuna, plus skinless chicken or turkey breast. Plant-based protein foods, especially lentils, chickpeas, black beans, and nuts and seeds. Low-fat dairy options, especially Greek yogurt and cottage cheese. Unsaturated fat foods, especially avocados, olive oil, and nuts and seeds. Hydrating foods and drinks, especially watermelon, cucumber, celery, and herbal teas. And don't forget to take advantage of glucose-stabilizing, anti-inflammatory spices and herbs, especially garlic, ginger, and turmeric.